We're back live at Candlestick Park here in San Francisco, where the hometown 49ers have their hands full with a very scrappy New Orleans Saints team looking for that first win after 13 consecutive losses. Hello again, everybody. Jim Kelly, Jim Hill alongside. We're at halftime. It is 35-7 in favor of the New Orleans Saints, on the verge, perhaps, unless a very dramatic comeback by the 49ers, of their first win of the season. Let's go to our videotape highlights now and take a look at just how it got to be 35-7. Take a look. Archie Manning went on top very early in the football game. Ike Harris, number 82. Watch the good concentration. Manning puts it right on the money. The up-and-go pattern turned around the cornerback, and Harris, the conversion by Benny Ricardo, that made it 7-0. The tight end, Henry Childs, we talked about him at the beginning of the telecast. In the right corner of the end zone, the same type of pattern, Jim Hill, and face masking against the defender, but Childs comes up with a big reception.
The outstanding thing about Childs' reception there is that he fell down and got back up and still made the catch.
Now, this one on the ground after a big play from Manning Dyke Harris, Jack Holmes behind a Tony Galbraith block, punches it on over. It's 21-0 with Ricardo's conversion, New Orleans at that point.
And here comes the 49ers' only touchdown, Freddie Solomon, a 57-yard punt return. He bumped into one of his own men, then broke it back down to the right, going down the far sideline. Russell Erksleben comes over the punter, tries to make a tackle on him. He pulls the muscle, falls down, and Solomon goes on in for the score.
And then Jack Holmes, number 45 again. He came into the football game having scored nearly a touchdown. He's scored two so far in the first half. Holmes right there. And then you take a look at Ike Harris, number 82 again, as the Saints had up their lead to 28-7. Great play by Archie Manning, rolling out to the right side. And watch Ike Harris.
Did an outstanding job of throwing the ball here by Archie. Harris coming across from left to right, total concentration on the ball, catches it right behind Cornelius, who really overran the ball, and goes on in for his second touchdown of the afternoon.
And that's how it got to be 35-7, and that's where we are right now. You heard the boos in the background. That means that the 49ers are back out onto the field. We'll be ready for the second half kickoff. The Saints lead it by a score of 35-7 when we come right back.
Introducing an American car built for a changing world and designed with a commitment to quality. The beautifully new Ford Granada. Contemporary in styling, energy efficient, smaller in size.
But not at the expense of room.
With Granada's highest mileage ratings ever. And with attention to detail. The kind of detail
you can see, feel, and hear.
The new Granada. Built in America for a changing world. From Ford.
Easy. You know, I was known for working long and hard during training camp. Why, even after my teammates were asleep, I'd still be out practicing my moves, and that's still important. So I drink light beer from Miller. Light tastes great. It's got a third less calories than a regular beer, and the best thing is it's less filling. Because, listen, I still train the same way as the old days. Practice, practice, practice.
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer, and less.
When you're hot, you're hot. The New Orleans Saints, you look at that, almost unbelievable. 20 first downs to just two for the San Francisco 49ers. Jimbo?
Total offensive yardage for the Saints, 324 to only 21 for San Francisco. You talk about hot, you're hot, and when you're not, you're not. Look at that. Look at the time of possession. 20 minutes and 28 seconds for the Saints, 9 minutes and 32 seconds for the 49ers. Outstanding job of the offensive line by the Saints. That's the reason for that.
Here's the kickoff by Benny Ricardo. That's Jimmy Owens, number 89, with the grab and then the muff. And he's in trouble and breaks the plane and gets it up to the 12-yard line and not much more. And, you know, you take a look at those stats, Jim Hill. I've got another stat for you. And if you're a 49er fan, it's not very encouraging because San Francisco has been outscored in the third quarter 85-41 by their opponents, and they're already down by a bunch, 28 to be exact. So kind of an ominous note for the San Francisco 49ers and that man, head coach Bill Walsh. As you look at Steve DeBerg to his left, DeBerg, the four-year man from San Jose State, 6'2", 205, was the starting quarterback, lost it to this man, Joe Montana. First down, 10 yards to go, San Francisco. At the 49er, 11-yard line. He goes up top. He's got Clark. Dwight Clark, the second-year man from Clemson. And that's the biggest 49er gain of the football game, with the exception of that 57-yard punt return by Freddie Solomon. Jimmy Marshall, the first-year man from Jackson State, number 23, beaten on the play. And Well, just like Solomon, they took the jet, not the local.
Well, and Clark is a pretty good receiver, too, and that's exactly what San Francisco is going to have to do the second half. They're going to have to put the ball up in the air. They're going to have to throw medium to deep passes. You're seeing Clark getting behind the secondary for the New Orleans Saints. They're going to have to get away from their back-oriented passes.
Montana and company, first and 10 at the New Orleans 40-yard line. He's got Linville Elliott looping out of the backfield, actually the safety valve receiver. Good job that time done by Joe Montana, because his primary receiver, Freddie Solomon, was all tied up down here at the 30-yard line by 44 David Wehmer. He looked off Solomon. He looked over the middle for his tight end, Charlie Young. He was covered, and he finally found Linville Elliott, the safety valve man.
And I think that's a good sign of a young quarterback who is gaining more and more maturity, because you are going from your primary to your secondary and then going over to your safety valve receiver.
There are the stats on Joe Montana, who was 8 out of 12 in the first half. Came out smoking, as they had to in the second half. Linville Elliott in motion. The pitch back to Earl Cooper, the rookie running back. He's got some real estate down inside the New Orleans Saints 28-yard line. Earl Cooper came into this football game averaging about 4.5 yards every time he touched the football on the ground. In the first half, he rushed for 8 yards on 4 carries. His longest gain from scrimmage was 6 yards.
And one of the things that people like about him, at least the 49er coaching staff, is not only is he a good runner, he's a good, tough runner. And there is a big difference.
Cooper picked up the first down for the 49ers. It's first and 10 to go at the New Orleans Saints 28-yard line. Linville Elliott has a combo on the right side. And he's got another San Francisco first down. Linville Elliott in the first half rushed for 14 yards. His longest gain from scrimmage was 4 yards. He picked up 14, so he's just doubled his rushing yardage with that carry. Groom, 78 in there on the tackle. Another first down for the 49ers. 3 successive first downs for Joe Montana. They've got to get on the scoreboard quickly, and they know it. Slot to the left side with Solomon moving into the slot. Charles Young, the tight end, split out a few yards on the right side. Montana with a straight drop. The Saints are coming. Montana did well just to get rid of the ball. Intended in the general vicinity of Linville Elliott, but actually I think he threw it away.
And so far, I think that Bill Walsh's halftime talk to his 49er ball club was very blunt and straight to the point. Let's get to work. I'm sure he added a few other descriptive adjectives to it, but that's exactly what's happened, and now they're coming out, and they have moved the ball the length of the field.
You see Bill Walsh to the left of Steve DeBerg. Walsh calls the play, makes the play selection, and then DeBerg, as we stay on it, with the wig-wag system, sends the play into Joe Montana, this man. Second down and 10 at the 14-yard line of the Saints, who lead by 28 points. The Saints are coming underneath. Down to about the 7-yard line. Good grab by Freddie Solomon. Lined up in a slot to the right side. The rookie from Notre Dame, David Wehmer, number 44, in there in the tackle, the right side cornerback.
Jim, in this series by the 49ers, we're seeing why San Francisco is a pass-oriented team. Backed up deep in their own territory, Montana completes a long pass out to Clark. Now they moved on down the field by the pass. And this is exactly what they're going to have to do the rest of the ball game in order to catch New Orleans.
Okay, they've gone to the two tight end alignment right now on 3rd down and 3. San Francisco 49ers showing run. Cooper wants to pass. Now he wants to run. He's got the first down inside the 4-yard line. Fumble, but not before Cooper was down. It'll be San Francisco's ball, first and goal, when they unpile. Donnie Schwartz, number 48, the third-year man from Washington State, the man who stuck it to Earl Cooper, but not before Cooper had put his head down and barreled for another San Francisco first down.
And that was a pretty good run fake by Cooper, run pass fake, I should say. Whenever you see a running back get the ball and he bends back deep in the backfield, you automatically think it's going to be a run pass. But that time, the Saints on defense didn't go for it. They kept covering their receivers in the secondary. And as you see right now, the ball is inside the 5-yard line.
Rafael Septien, a 32-yard field goal over in Oakland. The Cowboys have upped their lead to 9 points now. It's 19-10. Dallas on top over the Raiders. Montana to Earl Cooper. Close to the goal line. But they stack him up over on the right side, about a 0.5-yard shot.
And it looks like Cooper's a little slow in getting up. So far, The 49er offensive line is doing exactly what the Saint offensive line did in the first half. They're getting off on the ball, they're getting underneath the defensive people for New Orleans, and they're able to move them around.
That's Earl Cooper, number 49, the injured 49er, laying down at about the goal line right there. You take another look, and you'll see the way Ken Bortolan, number 50 of LSU, stuck it to Cooper, stacked him up just shy of the goal line. There's the hit right there, and down he goes and hurts that left knee. So it'll be second down, goal to go. The 49ers driving when we come right back.
I looked at Datsun 280ZX and Porsche 924 because I wanted a refined sports car. Then I looked at and drove this new Mazda RX-7, and that's all it took.
Just one look. That's all it took. Yeah, just one look. That's all it took.
The Mazda RX-7 keeps getting better. Even the mileage is 24% better than last year. And the more I looked, the more I liked the looks of its price.
The more you look, the more you like.
Introducing the revolutionary twin-action shaving system engineered to outperform twin blades, the new Norelco Rotatract Razor. Inside three floating heads, Rotatract works like twin blades to grip hair, raise it up, then razor it off hundreds of times a second for a shave that's twin blade close without a nick or cut. The new twin-action Norelco Rotatract Razor, cord and rechargeable. Twin blade closeness, but no gotcha.
Wednesday, when Blue Flu strikes the department, Enos becomes a one-man police force.
Promise me it ain't something crazy. Keep up with that.
Enos, Wednesday night.
Checking other action around the NFL, that big, big ball game in Oakland. Right now, the Dallas Cowboys lead the Oakland Raiders 19-10. Rafael Septian has just kicked a 34-yard field goal. Meanwhile, Kansas City leads Denver 28-7.
Don Woods, number 47, has replaced the injured Earl Cooper. Ex-San Diego Charger picked up in midseason. The 49ers in close, and they've got it. Joe Montana kept it himself. And it's now a 35-13 ball game. And coming out to try to make it 35-14 will be Ray Wershing, who's had a busy afternoon, but only kicking off. So Joe Montana goes in. Montana had thrown for 7 touchdowns coming into this football game. And you see the big hole clogged rather quickly after Montana knifed his way through. Snap is good, spot is better, and the kick is perfect. 35-14, 49ers take the opening kickoff in the second half, and they march right down very quickly against the New Orleans Saints. So it's a 21-point New Orleans advantage. Saints get the ball back when we come right back.
Welcome to Club Atari. What's your pleasure? Break up? Here's something new. Circus Atari.
Cartridges, video chess, football. Cartridge, sir. Fez is here.
We meet again, Fez.
Yes, a little game of Space Invaders, perhaps. What shall we play for?
For fun, of course.
No other company offers you as many different video game cartridges as Atari.
This man leads the good life. He puts on his bow tie, he puts on his tuxedo, and then he puts on his Accord LX, our most luxurious Honda, with features like variable assist power steering, digital clock and air conditioning as standard, with plush seats and deep pile carpeting. So, for people who lead the good life, the car that leads the simple life.
Simple. That one-yard touchdown plunge by Joe Montana, his second touchdown on the ground so far this year. We mentioned that he has already thrown for 7. And Joe not really seeing that much action, Jim Hill, until the New York Giant game 2 games ago. He started last week against the New England Patriots, and a big upset for the 49ers in that game, and got the call against the New York Giants, a 12-0 shutout in favor of the 49ers, and apparently has won the starting quarterback job from Steve DeBerg. Jimmy Rogers back deep at his own 7-yard line, looks for the wedge, hits it at the 25, and the 49ers hit him, and down he goes at the 27.
I think we'll get a chance now, Jim, to see if the Saints really deserve to win this ball game this afternoon. The thing that they must do now is they must continue to do what they did in the first half, and that is get an outstanding job of blocking from their offensive line and continue to attack the secondary for San Francisco.
Well, the veteran, Jim Peterczak, who limped off early in the first half and had his muscle taped up, has returned, the six-year veteran from Eastern Michigan, out over the ball. They'll keep it on the ground. The pitch back here. That's Tony Galbraith. Bobby Leopold, the rookie from Notre Dame, the man who got to him first off. Tony Galbraith having a big afternoon both in receiving and in rushing the football. As Manning is calling all of his own plays, Galbraith now 11 carries, 68 yards on the ground, and he has caught three passes for a total of 24 yards.
He's always been a good running back. He's always been a good back to have come out of the backfield and catch the pass. He's just been caught up in one of those things that when things go wrong for you, they go wrong all the way around.
He's a five-year veteran from Missouri, 6'1", 230 in the backfield now with Jack Holmes. And this is Jack Holmes who tries to punch his way up near the 35-yard line. It was second down and five. Picked up about 2 yards, so it'll bring up third down. Let's call it a long three. Jim Stuckey, 79, from Clemson. Archie Reese, 78, also from Clemson, in there on the stop. And the third man, San Francisco plays a 3-4 most of the time on the front three. Lawrence Pillars, 65, from Alcorn State. There is a nervous Bill Walsh who would like to get the ball back.
And we're getting a good chance of seeing just how good a coach he is. It's easy to coach when you're in front. Good sign when you can come from behind.
On third and three in short yardage. Will not get it. He'll be stacked up shy of first down yardage, and the Saints will have to relinquish the football. Stuckey in there again as you look at a concerned Dick Stanfill shaking his head. Might be wondering about the play call on that.
It appears, Jim, that New Orleans has gone pretty much into a shell, which is the worst thing that you can do when you get into a situation like this and you 0-13, because once you go into a shell and you get conservative, you don't do anything but let that other club just come on back, which is what the 49ers are going to try and do now.
Russell Erksleben averaging 44 yards per kick over the last four games, right around his average so far this afternoon, as you see there. Freddie Solomon, number 88, who has already rambled some 57 yards for the first 49er touchdown. He'll be looking up into the lights and into the sun as you look now at Russell Erksleben. Out of the snap of Jim Peterczak. Freddie Solomon will field it. And then he decides to let it go. You heard some oohs and ahs and some groans from some nervous 49er fans who thought the ball might have hit one of the 49ers down there, but not so, says referee Dick Jorgensen. So we've got now 8:55 left to go in the third quarter. The Saints are on top against the 49ers, 35-14.
Christmas card was sent to you by the people at Miller High Life. Merry Christmas.
Next week, a Super Sports Saturday, the Giants battle of the Redskins, followed by the Mixed Team Golf Classic and the Sports Spectacular with figure skating and the Great American Truck Race next Saturday on CBS Sports.
That is a very concerned San Francisco 49er brain trust on the sideline right there. That is Bill Walsh, the head coach, who has a 5-8 record coming in. Those five victories in 1980, by the way, represent more victories than 1978 and 79 combined for San Francisco. Montana goes up top quickly to Freddie Solomon, out of bounds at the 25-yard line, turned around by David Wehmer. And the Niners, as you might expect, Jim Hill, have to go to the air because they're down by 21 points, 35-14.
And they have New Orleans playing it rather soft up front. The secondary for the Saints really... they really don't want to give up the deep pass because of what happened on the last possession by San Francisco, and that's why the short stuff is open now.
Of course, by comparison right now, if you do have the Saints back on their heels a little bit defensively, a little bit cautious, a little concerned, you want to take what the defense is going to give you. That's a short pass. And that's what Montana's doing. That's the first down. up at about the 34-yard line. Montana had to get the quick release, and he got it to number 47, looping out of the backfield. Donnie Woods, the man who's come in to replace Linville Elliott or Earl Cooper. Joe Federspiel in there in the tackle, the 9-year veteran from Kentucky for the New Orleans Saints, but Montana picks up the first down. The line of scrimmage now to 34 of San Francisco. Cooper is out. We'll try to update his injury for you. He left with an injured left knee, it appeared, down near the goal line. He's been replaced by Donnie Woods, 47. As Montana looks to get out of trouble. You know, on that play, Jimmy, I don't think Don Woods knew whether the ball was thrown to him or to the tight end Charlie Young. Woods might have had a chance to grab that ball if he jumped up. He let it go, and it looked like it was just underthrown, intended for number 86, Charlie Young, the tight end.
That's one of the problems you have, Jim, when you have two people, two offensive receivers in the same area, because they don't know if you're throwing to them or to the other person. But as far as the Saints are concerned right now, with it being second down, we're going to have to start seeing some blitzing out of them, because the offensive line for San Francisco is starting to do a good job.
Second and 10 from the 34 of San Francisco. That's great. San Francisco touchdown, 66 yards. Joe Montana to number 87, Dwight Clark, his seventh touchdown grab of the season. And the 49ers, Jim Hill, are right back in this football game.
Well, New Orleans came with the blitz, but what happened was that San Francisco, their offensive line, caught the Saints in a blitz. They were expecting it just like we were. You see the blitz coming from the top of your screen. Linebacker coming in. Clark coming from the top, from right to left. Does a great job of getting away from defensive people. Actually, he should have been tackled. That was a bad job of tackling by the Saints. And as a
result, was Waymer that missed the tackle. Now, this is number 89, James Owens, who helps throw the block after Solomon threw another one to allow Clark to turn the corner. And Ray Wershing will try to put the 21st 49er point up on the board now, out of the hold of Joe Montana. It's perfect. 7:52 left to go in the third quarter right now. And the Saints, who led it 35-7 at halftime, have seen the 49ers put 14 unanswered points on the board. New Orleans gets the kickoff, and we come right back. We've got 7:52 to go. The score, the Saints 35, the 49ers 21, and coming back.
Every year, millions of drivers suffer the agony of hillophobia. The fear of stopping on hills with a stick shift, with cars behind you, very close behind you. The only known cure? The ingenious Hill Holder Clutch from Subaru. Now you don't have to go downhill until you want to. Subaru. Inexpensive. And built to stay that way.
Mom, we got a present for you.
When you get home. Let's go.
You can install the Stanley do-it-yourself garage door opener in about 4 hours. Everything comes in the box. Just assemble it, put it up, and plug it in.
Surprise.
The Stanley do-it-yourself garage door opener.
Push it.
It's a very nice thing to do for somebody else.
He did it so fast.
We want to help you do things right.
This Christmas, open the door for someone you love. Give a Stanley garage door opener.
Tuesday, Michael Learned and John Houseman star in the television premiere of A Christmas Without Snow, a heartwarming story destined to become a family holiday classic. Tuesday night.
You look at Ray Wershing, all set to boot it away to a nervous New Orleans Saints football team right now. They've had 14 points scored on them in a little over 7 minutes of play. Joe Montana has thrown for his 12th touchdown toss of the season. The seventh touchdown grab by number 87, Dwight Clark. Montana's also rushed for one. Freddie Solomon has gone 57 yards with a punt return. And the 49ers trying to come back. And you can see their defense, their specialty teams, Jim Hill, are fired up and playing much more inspired football than they did in the first half, when they fell behind by 28 points.
And on the other side of the coin, the Saints have gone into a shell. It seems now that they are playing not to win, but to keep from getting beat. And when you have that kind of offensive approach, you're going to get beat.
Well, just like the scoring drive that preceded it, this one didn't take much time. Just 1:03 on the clock. A 71-yard bomb from Montana to Clark. and it just took four plays. So now we'll see what Manning and company will do. They would like to obviously take a little bit of the sting, a little bit of the momentum away from the San Francisco 49ers, and the only way you do that is by picking up a couple of first downs. From the 26, Manning fakes the handoff to Tony Galbraith, looks downfield, he's got Wes Chandler at the 45. Dwight Hicks, the second-year man from Michigan, was beaten, but you really can't say he was beaten because the ball was thrown right on the money by Archie Manning, and a picture-perfect catch by that man, number 89, Wes Chandler.
Archie knows that Wes has tremendous athletic ability, Jim, and that he can get up in the air and go after those passes, and that's why he threw the ball just a little bit high so that Wes could go up and get it.
It started in New Orleans where they call him the eight bags, and it spread out to San Francisco. A couple of bag heads there. 7:02, clock is running. Pitch back to Tony Galbraith. Gets a lead block. Not much doing. Gets back to the line of scrimmage. Maybe picks up a half a yard before Jim Stuckey stuck it.
This game may end up being a lot closer than it appeared to be in the first half when the Saints were really just blowing them on out. But I think that when Archie went to the sidelines, he talked a little with his coaching staff, and they really feel that they were in their shell just a couple of minutes ago, and now they need to get out of it.
You saw the stats on Archie Manning before. He passed for 314 yards on opening day when San Francisco won 26-23. Open man, Henry Charles. Fumbles the ball. San Francisco's got it. Henry Childs had the first down, was battling for more. The ball was stripped loose, and Terry Totolo, the five-year man from UCLA, in there on the tackle, the man who fell on the football, the man who stripped him of the ball, the man we are promoting as All-Pro here this afternoon because he really stayed with his football game in the first half, Danny Buns, number 57. Another look.
Well, you really have no one to blame here but Childs himself, because he did come up with a fine catch, but he was carrying the ball the way you really shouldn't, and that's why the 49ers got it back.
There's Buns with a strip right there. Terry Totolo falls on the football. We've got 6:10 to go in the third quarter. The 49ers coming back.
It was Mercedes-Benz that produced the world's first production diesel car, the first five-cylinder diesel car, this 200-mile-per-hour diesel car, the first turbocharged diesel car, and the world's only 3,000-mile-per-gallon diesel vehicle. For 1981, only Mercedes-Benz can apply all that expertise to these diesel cars. Mercedes-Benz, the pioneer in diesels for 45 years.
Hatfield's gas pipes were leaking half our gas, but the town couldn't afford a contractor to fix them.
See if you can break them out.
So when Bill Sanders of Phillips showed us gas pipe made of their plastic and how to install it ourselves, we were in hog heaven. With some willing hands and some expert advice from Phillips, now Hatfield, Arkansas is really cooking. And that new pipe paid for itself in a year.
Phillips Petroleum. Good things for cars and the people who drive them.
Those are some of the various high school cheerleaders from around the San Francisco Bay Area. San Francisco, unlike the Dallas Cowboys and Philadelphia Eagles with their Liberty Bells, do not have a professional organized group of cheerleaders. They like to stay with the pure amateurism, if you will, using high school students. The girls look real good. 35-21, San Francisco on a roll right now. It was 35-7 at intermission. Second half has been all San Francisco, but of course New Orleans had a pretty good drive stopped right there when Henry Childs was stripped of the ball, and it's a big break for San Francisco. They stay on the ground to Linville Elliott. He picks up just 2 yards. Second down and eight. Not a bad call, Jim Hill, on first down, because they've been going to the pass. You've got New Orleans thinking about the pass. You come back with a run. Try to mix them up a little bit.
That's right, because the 49ers burned them a couple of series ago on first down.
Line of scrimmage now, the 49er 15-yard line. Wide receivers are left and right. Montana has to go up top. Open man out of the backfield. Earl Cooper in the grass. Down he goes. Number 56 for the Saints gets to him. Reggie Mathis, second-year man from Oklahoma, helped out by David Waymer, and we might have unnecessary roughness. You see the preliminary indication by Dick Jorgensen, the referee. personal foul, unnecessary roughness. Cooper was stopped way shy of first down yardage, so this will give the 49ers another first down.
There are certain penalties, Jim. Here's a call.
Personal foul, unnecessary roughness, blow to the head, 44 defense. First down.
That's why it was called a blow to the head. If you go inside and you want to hit someone, if you hit them from the head down, then that's okay. Sometimes they'll let you get away with it. But anytime you attack that head and the officials think it's you're purposely attacking the head, they're going to throw the flag on you.
That's the second penalty for a total of 20 yards against the New Orleans Saints. Montana on first and 10 from his own 33-yard line. In the grasp of and down he goes, a good New Orleans Saint rush. That's Mr. Grooms again, Mrs. Grooms' little boy. 6'4 and 260.
And one of the things that enabled Grooms to make the sack was number 96, Steve Parker, went in. And just as Montana originally got to release the ball, Parker put his hand up in the air, and then Joe couldn't see his receiver, so he pulled it back down. Grooms went in and made the sack. See, right there, that's when Parker really forced Montana to reload. Grooms came in, got the sack.
That's the fourth sack for a total of 30 yards for the New Orleans Saints. Their defensive front four have been doing a whale of a job. Montana, little flare pass. Dwight Clark, he broke the last one, close to a first down. Boy, he's quick for a fellow that's 6'3 and 205. 17-yard pickup on the play. Tommy Myers in there on the tackle. Shy of first down yardage. Now an interesting play call for Bill Walsh. Third down, about a yard and a half to go. Walsh will call the play. Steve DeBerg will wigwag it in with the hand signals. Kind of like being a flagman on an aircraft carrier, huh?
Sure is, but it's a way of keeping your backup quarterback in the game himself just in case something happens and he has to go in.
Montana now 16 of 22, 189 yards. That was Clark's fifth reception. Earl Cooper's in trouble, will not get the first down. Kind of a strange play call because really the 49ers have been very ineffective in running wide against the New Orleans Saints here this afternoon. And both of the cornerbacks for New Orleans have been doing a fine job. Waymer on the right side, Ricky Ray, Don Schwartz over on the left side. And that time it was Joe Federspiel who strung the play out, did the job. So Jim Miller's in to punt again.
Anytime you make that ball carrier run lateral to the line of scrimmage for more than 8 or 9 yards, you have a chance of throwing him for a loss.
Wes Chandler lets it hit. Finally touched there by a 49er, and Archie Manning and company will break out. First down, 10 yards to go. They're on top by a score of 35-21. We are more than midway in the third quarter now. We've got 3:25 left to go in the third quarter. You look at a very concerned Bill Walsh. Well, we've got a great week for you next week on Super Sports Saturday here on CBS. First, the NFL Today will kick off with a special edition that leads to a clash between the Giants and the Redskins. And you know what a great long rivalry that has been. Archie Manning from his own 28-yard line. Little pop to Tony Galvin. In trouble, gets away from it. Shouldn't carry the football out there like a loaf of bread, but he's close to first down yardage. We talk about the Giants and the Redskins and what a great and long rivalry that's been. That's next Saturday on Super Sports Saturday. Then some of the best men and women golfers in the country pair up for a mixed team classic. Strategy and teamwork critical, of course, in any golf tournament. That's not all. The CBS Sports Spectacular brings you some of the brightest young skating talent at the World Junior Figure Skating Championships. And then the wild and woolly Great American Truck Race rounds out a great afternoon next week on Super Sports Saturday right here on CBS. Second down, short ball. Manning operates with Jack Holmes. Jimmy Rogers, that's Jack Holmes. He's got the first down. He keeps it on the ground, keeps that clock moving.
And don't get in the shell. That's exactly what Dick Stanfield is saying on the sidelines. Don't get conservative. You've been very successful in having a wide-open game right from the beginning. Don't do it now, because if you do, then you start to create mistakes. You give the 49ers a chance to come back. That's looking at it from the New Orleans Saints standpoint. From the 49ers standpoint, you want to hold them on this series of downs, try and get another score in. That way you're only 7 points down when you go into the fourth period.
Speaking of comebacks, Chris Barr, 38-yard field goal. The Raiders now trail Dallas by six. It's 19-13 there in the third quarter. They fake the end around to Child, set up the screen to the halfback Holmes. He's got a Conmore up to midfield. San Francisco reacted very quickly defensively. Jim did a good job up near first down yardage. They'll have to measure.
That's what I was talking about, Jim, about don't go into your shell. Don't get conservative. Leave the game wide open. You're 0-13 so far this season. You must do things that can create interest for your ball players and so they can have fun out on the field. And that's what's happening right now. Not only is it good for the same ball players, I think it's good for the people in New Orleans to see this kind of wide open offense because you know it can attract their attention.
Well, they have measured. It is a first down for the New Orleans Saints. Keep that clock moving a little bit. Try to put a sustained drive together. You know, Don Shula, the great Dolphins coach, says that the best way to silence a very enthusiastic home crowd is with a long, sustained scoring drive. Takes a little bit of the start down.
One,
the midfield stripe, Manning from the eye. Quick toss. Wes Chandler cannot hang on. He gets popped pretty good by number 26 down there for San Francisco. Ray Rhodes, the ex-New York Giant. 7-year veteran from Tulsa.
And as I look at the St. Ball Club, Jim, they do have some pretty good football players. There's an update on the Dallas-Oakland game. The Cowboys leading the Raiders 19-13 in the third period. The Saints have some pretty good football players. They don't have the great depth that other teams have, but in certain areas, they have some doggone good football players.
Wes Chandler wide to the right side. Hank Harris split out wide to the left side. Running backs are Holmes and Galbraith again. It's second down and 10. Manning to toss it up, looks at the blitz. Looks to Henry Childs. You will not see a finer catch than that. Flag was thrown after the hit. I believe they'll call pass interference on the rookie, Ricky Churchman, who had two interceptions last week. Number 33 from Tennessee. But what a great catch by Henry Childs. He was hit. He was on his way down. He maintained his momentum, followed the ball right into the numbers, and hung on.
Interference, 33, defense, decline, first down.
Take another look.
You know, and Archie really zipped the ball in there, too. Outstanding job. You see him step up into the pocket. The line is blocking all the people around him. And now watch Childs. He's sliding on his back. The ball comes in right under his chin. He hangs on for the catch despite the pass interference.
Line of scrimmage now, the 34-yard line of the San Francisco 49ers. They have scored 14 straight points. Saints trying to take a little bit of the start shot right now. Put some points on the board themselves. Galbraith behind Jack Holmes. Does well just to get 1 yard on the play. Ricky Churchman, number 33, that rookie from Texas again. 6'1", 193. And there, submarined him down low and knifed him down. Less than a minute to go in the third quarter now. 35-21, the Saints 0-13 coming in. Been a long year. Wes Chandler wide to the right side. Split out wide to the left side is Ike Harris, and Manning will go up top. Ike Harris, he missed it. That's one of the few times in the entire football game where you see Manning miss his receiver, and he knows it.
The 49ers are getting no pressure at all on Archie Manning. None whatsoever from their defensive alignment. They're going to have to do some stunning up front, try and confuse the blocking assignments for the Saints. Blitz just a little bit. Do something else that they haven't been doing all afternoon long because Archie's just had great pass protection by his line.
Manning now 19 of 29, 342 yards. You look at the third down conversions. New Orleans, by the way, the NFL's poorest third down offense. The Saints had converted only about 30% of their third down plays. And Manning's got all kinds of room to run. And it closed up quickly. They shut him down about 2, maybe 3 yards shy of first down yardage. Boy, great reaction that time by Lawrence Pillars over there. Archie Reese and the left side cornerback Ray Rhodes came up to pinch Manning down. So Benny Ricardo will try a three-pointer.
And he's really going to have to get his foot into this one because the wind is swirling down on the field. And it may appear like it's in his favor when, again, it may not be.
Well, when he does come back to try it, he'll be doing it the other way because that's the end of the third quarter. We've got 15 minutes left in regulation. The New Orleans Saints, 0-13, trying to put victory number one up there on the board. They've got a 14-point lead against San Francisco when we come right back. Now a word from...
Thursday, December 11th, a special two-hour premiere of Magnum P.I. Even with Hawaii as a playground, Magnum's idea of fun is danger. A special two-hour premiere, December 11th.
This is CBS.
I'll tell you, if Dick Stanfill has got a fake punt in the playbook, I can't think of a better time to utilize it right now. They have disdained the field goal try because a little bit out of Benny Ricardo's range, I guess, going into the wind. But now you look at the line of scrimmage at the 28-yard line. It's fourth down and four. Why not go for it? It's as good as a punt. I don't know about that, Jamil.
Not at all.
Erks Lehman faked the punt or faked the pass. Of course, what you do in a situation like that is risk having your offensive line leave the line of scrimmage too early, and usually there's a penalty call. That time, though, they wisely held. It goes into the end zone, so they start on the 20-yard line. So what it all amounts to is a net gain for New Orleans of 8 yards. But I think on fourth and four, if you're going to punt for it, you might as well go for the first down and try to score.
Especially when you're down that close. You're absolutely correct.
49ers start from their 20-yard line. Montana looks for Freddie Solomon. Batted away. Great play by Ken Bortolan. Four-year man from LSU, 6'4", 226. He's got great speed for an outside linebacker because Freddie Solomon had turned the cornerback around and he was open on a post pattern.
The Saints then were playing in a zone defense, Jim, and the linebackers must get good depth. On the snap of the ball, they must turn and run to their specific area at a 45-degree angle. And when he did that, that's what allowed him to knock the ball down. Good job.
Second down and 10 for Montana and company. The man you're looking at, number 44, is David Wehmer, the rookie from Notre Dame. Of course, Joe Montana, secondary man from South Bend also. Ex-Irish teammates. Montana looks. Linville Elliott wanted nothing to do with that football and showed it. He heard footsteps on the play. As Matthews, 56, was in hot pursuit. 6'2", 220, a Sooner from Oklahoma. And they're talking to each other on the way back to the huddle. Quarterbacks don't talk to receivers who don't try for a ball like that very often, do you?
No, they don't. They just kind of look at them in a very strange way.
Steve DeBert with a wig-wag, the play call from Bill Walsh. Third down and 10, line of scrimmage still the 20-yard line. Slot to the left side. Lone running back is Don Woods, number 47. Picks up on the snap. Montana covers it. And the 49ers will have to punt it away.
You know, what you said a little while ago, Jim, was completely true. The Saints took the ball and they drove down the field and it got this crowd quiet just a little bit. And now New Orleans has come back and they've had a pretty successful series on defense and about to get the ball in pretty good field position.
Jimmy Miller has had a busy afternoon for the 49ers. Wes Chandler signaling for the fair catch, makes it at his own 46-yard line. And that's where Archie Manning and the Saints will operate first and 10. A 38-yard punt, no return on the fair catch. We've got 14:27 left to go in the fourth quarter. The score, the New Orleans Saints 35, the San Francisco 49ers 21.
This ranch doesn't run without horses. And the horses don't run without you. But when you've hammered out a day's work, you meet up with Miller Time.
When it's time to relax.
Time for the best tasting beer you can find.
One beer stands clear.
Miller High Life.
If you've got the time, we've got the beer.
The 1981 Honda Prelude is a pleasure to look at in many different ways. You can look at it as a sporty car with front-wheel drive and sleek, racy looks. You can look at it as a comfortable car with a luxurious interior and power steering that comes with the optional automatic. You can look at it as an economy car. After all, it is a Honda. But then again, you can look at it like this.
Honda, we make it simple.
Jim Zorn and the Seahawks trying to come back against the New York Giants. The New Yorkers started Scott Bruner, a rookie out of Delaware, instead of Phil Sims at quarterback today. And the Seahawks are now ahead by 1 point. You look at the folks who are nice and comfortable out there sitting in the sunshine at Candlestick. The folks on the other side are sitting in the shade with a few blankets and thermoses wrapped around themselves, trying to stay warm here as the winds whip around. 14:27 left to go in regulation. Archie Manning with a handoff to Jack Holmes. He does well to get it to the midfield stripe. Picks up 3, second down and 7. Bobby Leopold, a rookie from Notre Dame, in there on the tackle. San Francisco with a rookie from Notre Dame in Bobby Leopold. And, of course, the Saints have number 44, rookie cornerback David Wehmer.
That was a very interesting statement we just saw on the screen then, Jim. The Saints have won 4 out of 5 games from San Francisco. Why one team dominates another? One of the big mysteries in sports.
Well, actually, the Saints had won the last 4 games until the San Francisco 49ers took that 26-23 decision at the start of the 1980 campaign. Rodgers, the ball carrier. Keena Turner went underneath, the rookie from Purdue, submarined him down low. You look at San Francisco's defense, they've got some good rookies. Bobby Leopold from Notre Dame, Turner from Purdue. And slowly under Bill Walsh, they're turning things around. Again, the 5 victories this season for San Francisco represent more than 78 and 79 combined for the 49ers. It's 3rd down and 3. They show run formation. Holmes in there now with Jimmy Rogers. Holmes behind Ikaris, and Jimmy Rogers has got a lot of room. 1st down and more. The saving tackle made by Dwight Hicks. That's what happens when you bunch everybody up close.
You bunch everybody up close, and not a good job at all of playing that sweep by San Francisco, because they didn't get a support man up on the outside to turn the sweep man back to the inside. Everyone on the field on every play has a specific assignment, and if you look at someone on offense, he will tell you exactly what you should do. That particular time, the secondary for San Francisco was at fault because the cornerbacks didn't come up to make the ball carrier turn back to the inside.
You take a look at that graphic on the New Orleans Saints. They rushed for 103 yards last week in their loss to Minnesota. Only the 2nd time that New Orleans had rushed for over. Oh. You could hear that one. Wayne Wilson. The 1st time they rushed for over 100 yards was back on October 26th against Washington, when they got 220 yards against the Skins. Today so far they have rushed for 124 yards, about 130 with that last bone-crunching gain by Wayne Wilson. So it's the 3rd time they go over the 100-yard mark. Ray Rhodes in there on the tackle. Ouch, that one hurt.
Sure did. You can just see it out there when they walk back to the huddle.
2nd down and 8 from the 24-yard line of San Francisco. 49ers have to keep New Orleans off the scoreboard here to have any chance of pulling this game out. And Jimmy Rogers fumbles the ball, and the 49ers get it back. Well, no sooner do we say San Francisco's got to keep him off the board, Jim Hill, when they force that turnover. There were some tickets available. That is not the man who made the fumble recovery. That is the man who got the lateral, number 52 for San Francisco, Bobby Leopold. You take another look. As the pitchback went to Jack Holmes, to Jimmy Rogers, rather. Rogers coughed up the ball. Stripped loose right there. Picked up by number 29, Jared Williams. We'll be right back.
You're looking at a revolutionary GTE Sylvania street light bulb that uses 10% less energy than the bulb it replaces. But the truly amazing part is, it gives more light. An almost unbelievable 80% more light. Imagine using 10% less energy and getting 80% more light.
Gee.
No, GTE.
I'm Joe Duncan, State Farm agent, Cincinnati, Ohio, speaking for thousands of State Farm agents around the country. You know, there are a lot of reasons why people come to State Farm agents and stick with State Farm agents year after year. I think one of the big reasons is service. State Farm built its reputation on service. People expect it, they are paying for it, and we deliver.
And like a good neighbor, State Farm is...
So far, he has dribbled tennis balls, juggled some footballs, a machete and a hatchet, and now a couple of torches. First down, 10 yards to go for Joe Montana and company from their own 17-yard line. They force what could be a key turnover. They're down by 14. They've got 12 left to go. And if they don't get greedy, there's plenty of time left. Handoff to Donnie Woods. Good job defensively by the New Orleans Saints to close it off very quickly. That's Chuck Evans, the rookie, number 59, 6'3", 235, who came up very, very quickly. And the 49er faithful, but few remain here at Candlestick, not very happy with the play caller.
I think they thought that maybe the 49ers should be passing now, but you brought up a very interesting point. 11 minutes and 45 seconds left in the ball game. San Francisco will get their hands on the ball at least two times, so they must take advantage of every time they have the ball and score.
They'll have to pass now on second down and long yardage. In and out of the hands of number 80 for the 49ers, Eason Ramson, who just checked in, the third-year man from Washington State, 6'2", 234. And you can see that Joe Montana is a little displeased with that because the ball was right in his hands. No reason that ball should not have been caught. Clock is stopped, 11:28. Ramson stays in at tight end. Charles Young is out. Wide receivers are Dwight Clark, number 87, Freddie Solomon, number 88. On third down conversions, the 49ers are a woeful 1 out of 8. And they need 9 yards here to keep the football. Saints are coming. Archie goes to Lindell Elliott. First down and more. Joe Montana, what a job he did to get rid of that football. I called Archie. We watched Archie do it all afternoon. Joe Montana in the grasp of
somewhat of a delayed blitz here, Jim, by 56 Reggie Mathis, who has to go back and catch Linville Elliott, because if Mathis doesn't come out and at least give it that effort, then Elliott could go out a lot further than he did.
Ray Brown, 27 on the tackle, big third down play. 2 out of 9 in third down conversions now of the 49ers. Good pass protection this time, and he's got his hand, and down goes Dwight Clark. He's in the grasp of number 59 for the New Orleans Saints. Jimmy Marshall, 23, helped out, but the man who got to it first was Chuck Evans. And I want to tell you, Dwight Clark obviously felt that as Evans really bopped. Montana goes over to take a look and also to confer with Bill Walsh on the sidelines. We've got 10 and a half left to go in regulation. The Saints are on top, 35-21. San Francisco trying to come back.
Introducing the new World Car, Ford Escort, with better ideas from around the world at your fingertips. Road-hugging four-wheel independent suspension, front-wheel drive, precise rack and pinion steering, stabilizer bar for tight turns, new power-efficient engine for easy freeway cruising, and higher gas mileage ratings than Rabbit, Accord, Corolla hatchback. Ford Escort, built in America to take on the world.
You still catch tuna the old way, with strong poles and strong arms.
Yeah, let's take them home.
But now comes Miller time.
When it's time to relax.
Time for the best tasting beer you can find.
One beer stands clear.
America's quality beer, Miller High Life.
If you've got the time, we've got the beer.
Next Sunday here on CBS, these Saints will be at Shea Stadium to take on the New York Jets. St. Louis, one of three teams to defeat Philadelphia at Veterans Stadium. Atlanta plays host to the 49ers, and the Bucs will be at Detroit. That, of course, will be followed by the final round of the Mixed Team Golf Classic, all coming up next Sunday on CBS. Line of scrimmage, the 41-yard line of the 49ers. It's second down and 5, slot to the red side. Montana splits his running backs. looks for somebody, anybody, to come back and help him out. And Stutter steps down the sideline. There's a case, Jimmy Hill. He was really looking for Freddie Solomon. Solomon didn't know what was going on behind him. He was down about the 40-yard line, working one-on-one with Dave Wehmer, the rookie out of Notre Dame. Solomon never turned around to look back toward Montana. If he had, he would have come back and tried to help the quarterback out. It didn't happen, and as a result, Montana, looking over the bench for another play call, said, okay, help me out here.
That's one of the things that a good receiver must do. I'm surprised that Freddie didn't do it. Whenever you break downfield, look back to the quarterback. When you see him scrambling around, you have to break off your pattern and adjust to him.
There you see the third down conversions. And the Niners need a yard. Good play call. Montana keeps it. Goes up top to Freddie Solomon. Incomplete. No flags. Now, if you're Bill Walsh, do you go for it on fourth and one? 10 minutes to go in the football game at your own 45? I think you have to. Another look. The fake to Linville Elliott into the line. No place to go. Now, right here, Jimmy, if he hit Solomon on a post pattern, he was open, but he goes deep. Solomon has the option to cut underneath or go long. He went long just off his fingertips.
I think what Montana saw then was the other secondary person coming around, and he wanted to let Freddie get in back of the whole secondary rather than cut it short.
10 minutes even left to go in the football game. This is it for the 49ers. They need the first down. They need to keep possession of the football. Linville Elliott's got the first down. Knights over the right side. Randy Cross, Keith Barnhorst opening up the hole. Ray Brown, 27, the 10-year veteran from West Texas State. 6'2", 202 in there on the stop. 9:45, but the clock now working in favor of the New Orleans Saints.
We just got a injury report on Dwight Clark. He has a hip injury, and it's not known if he's going to return it.
Not exactly a defensive struggle here this afternoon. 56 points put on the board so far. That's Charles Young, the big tight end, and that's another San Francisco first down. Montana had a notion to run at that time, and then he turned Charlie Young in. 16-yard pickup on the play. Joe Federspiel in there on the stop.
In previous games against the Saints, whenever a team has started to really drive down the field against them, like the 49ers are doing now, it changed their defensive alignment just a little bit and start to blitz more in order to get more pressure on the quarterback. The 49ers now doing a pretty good job of holding out the Saints defensive line. Maybe they're trying to adjust that some and give us some blitzing.
You saw a very nervous Dick Stanfill over on the Saints bench. He's added about 10,000 more miles. Good call. Draw play. Donnie Woods rambles for 9 more yards. Darylin Moore, 74, the 8-year man from Oklahoma, in there on the stop. The play set in by Bill Walsh. He knew that the Saints would be looking for the pass. They ran the draw play up the middle. Second down and one.
And that always makes that defensive line a little bit more aware of what's going on the other side of the line of scrimmage. A draw play, a screen. Excellent calling on that play.
There's Bill Walsh with a headset on. Steve DeBerg in the jacket. Out wide to the left side now is Freddie Solomon. Don Woods simply sliding out of the backfield. Ken Bordelon in there on the tackle. That's what you try to do, Jimmy. Isolate that back coming out of the backfield on a linebacker. It usually works.
And now the 49ers have New Orleans completely off balance because they are showing them a wide variety of offensive plays. Long passes, medium, short, draw plays, sweeps, stuff off tackle. This is doing nothing but helping them move right on down the field.
Well, the New York Giants, we talk about the rookie from the Delaware, Scott Bruner, a 50-yard touchdown pass to Ernest Gray. 20-14 now, Giants over Seattle. From the 24-yard line, inside handoff, Linville Elliott fights all the way down to the 15-yard line. Joe Federspiel on the stop. And that's close to first down yardage once again. Solomon now checks back into the lineup, number 88. Jimmy Robinson, number 85, the 5-year man from Georgia Tech, checks back out. We're going to have ourselves a football game if San Francisco gets on the board.
It's been an outstanding drive by the 49ers this series. Oh, they've really taken it to the Saints. The Saints are starting to, it looks like they're getting just a little bit fatigued and they're standing up just a little bit too high. Another thing that I've noticed, Jim, is physically, I don't think that the Saints are as strong as the 49ers. I don't know if it has to do with their offseason weight lifting program or if they lift weights during the season. But I think that maybe they need to work on that just a little bit next year, because this is a time of the ball game when you have to depend a lot on your physical strength.
We talk about the success of this drive, the importance of this drive. Let's not forget it all began with a key turnover that the San Francisco 49ers forced. They forced the fumble when the Saints were on the verge of maybe scoring again and putting it out of reach. Even a field goal would have made it impossible. Short yardage situation. They fake their plunge into the line. Montana up top. Touchdown. Don Woods for a penalty play. Back in the 49er backfield. This is in the vicinity of holding. Fetterspiel and Bordeland in there on the tackle, but it'll negate a San Francisco first down. Montana was 20 out of 30 for 232 yards before that play. You can see a little frustrated right there, hands on his hips. Well, that's a very costly penalty, Jimmy.
Holding, number 71, offense, still second down.
Keith Von Horst, the veteran from Minnesota. They would have had it first down, goal to go from the 7 of the Saints. It's all the way back at the 25-yard line, second down and 11. So they lost 18 yards on the play. Linville Elliott gets the penalty back. Ray Brown, number 27, on the stop.
Good offensive play then, Jim, for the simple reason San Francisco put a man in motion, and by doing that you take away one more defensive player from the side in which you're going to run. That particular time they knew who was going to be on that opposite side where the sweep was going, and that's why they picked up the first down.
You're a former ball player. That's 18 Bob in the San Francisco playbook. Look at Kansas City, what they're doing to Denver.
That's really amazing. 31-14 Kansas City.
First down, 10 yards to go. 6:41 left to go. Look out, blitz from the left side. Joe Montana unloads to Freddie Solomon. Touchdown, San Francisco. No flags. What a job Joe Montana did to get rid of that football. James Marshall, the man that had a first shot at him, Waymer had a shot at him, and Freddie Solomon, Mr. Lightning, has struck very quickly. Watch from the left side. Number 50 coming in for the New Orleans Saints. Ken Bordeland right here. And somehow Montana gets rid of the football just before he goes down. Solomon does the rest on his own. Marshall can't get him. Waymer comes over. He can't get him. That's six.
Just a great individual effort.
Anybody imagine 35-7 at halftime?
We're going to have a wild finish on our hands.
Big point here for Ray Worsham. We've got flag day down there. And it's by no means automatic for Mr. Ray Worsham. He has had trouble with extra points this year. He's had three attempts blocked, and he's missed two others.
False start, number 71, offense, 5-yard penalty, and a retry.
That's Von Horst again, and that's hurt. That'll hurt him, because now it's by no means automatic. This becomes a field goal. Line of scrimmage. Well, he'll put it down at about the 15-yard line. This is a 25-yarder. Out of the hold of Joe Montana. Flags are down again. The kick was good, but penalty flags all over the field. So let's check with Dick Jorgensen, the referee. Worshing says, come on, guys, what are you doing? 49ers say it's against New Orleans. They'll take it after the kickoff. What a comeback by the San Francisco 49ers. They trail.
Number 80,
35-7.
The point is good. We'll kick off from the 40-yard line.
They trailed 35-7 at the half. They have come back with 21 unanswered points. They trail by 7. We've got 6:29 to go. The score, New Orleans 35, San Francisco 28.
Here's another Radio Shack Christmas gift idea. Soft, cuddly animals with a surprise inside. A radio. What a delightful gift. There's a raccoon, comic cat, brown spaniel, Pekingese, cuddly cat, and country mouse. It's a musical menagerie for kids and teens alike. The gift-priced pettable portable radios. Only at Radio Shack, your Christmas electronics store.
I'm not very good at this, but here.
It's the thrill that you feel when your dreams become real. It's the look in her eyes when she's caught by surprise. Like the moment you met, that you'll never forget.
Christmas is over.
When you give diamonds, you get so much in return.
Oh, honey.
Make the magic last forever.
Jim Kelly and Jim Hill back with you from Candlestick Park in San Francisco. Ray Wershing on your right, all set to kick it off. Jimmy Rogers on your left, about to receive. The penalty has been enforced on the kickoff. It was offsides New Orleans, so Wershing, not the deepest of kickoffs, will boom this one away from the 40-yard line. Rogers awaits in the vicinity of his own 2-yard line. To the 25-and-a-half-yard line with 6 minutes, Jim Hill, and 19 seconds to go in regulation. And you've got to think in terms of overtime right now if New Orleans cannot pick up a couple of first downs.
And if New Orleans goes into a shell this late in the ballgame, it will come back to haunt them. That's one thing, that's something I just saw out on the ball field that was very impressive, really impressive. The Saints all came together, put their hands together and said, hey, this is the most important series of this ballgame. If we're going to get our first win of the year, we must move it now.
We must hang on to the football. Both benches are up, sideline to sideline right now. We've got a dandy. Manning fell on the football. The Saints retained possession. Everybody's a little nervous right now. The momentum has changed definitely in the second half. It's been all San Francisco in the second stanza. It appeared that the New Orleans Saints were on a drive. They had it inside the 20-yard line of San Francisco that looked like the very least they'd come away with would be a field goal. The 49ers forced the fumble. They marched right down the field. They've drawn to within 7 after trailing by 28 points. Second down, loss of 1 on the preceding play. Flag on the play. Manning throws it over by that jugular. Danny Buns, 57, the man that was putting all kinds of pressure on Archie Manning. I'll tell you what, if we had an award for outstanding defensive player of this football game, I would give it to Danny Buns, number 57.
It would be him.
Number 45, offense, decline, third down.
Jack Holmes went in motion. 49ers will decline the penalty, keep the down box a moving. Third and 11. Now you've got to put the ball up.
So what New Orleans has done, they've wasted 2 plays. Fumble on one, penalty on the other.
This is be careful time. Got to look for a sideline pass here. You don't want to throw anything over the middle that might be deflected. So what do? They go to Tony Gabbert over the middle, but he's shy of first down yardage. Bobby Leopold, the rookie out of Notre Dame, in there on the stop, and the San Francisco 49ers are playing themselves one whale of a second half, the same way that the New Orleans Saints played themselves one whale of a second half last week against the Minnesota Vikings. New Orleans was down 23-20. They came back only to fall short by just those 3 points. As you look at Russell Erksleben, and you look at Freddie Solomon, who's already busted one for 57, this will be holding against San Francisco, and it'll back them up a little bit further. Dave Washington in there on the tackle. A 42-yard punt. A little bit of a return by Freddie Solomon, but it's going to be hurt by a holding call against the 49ers. Well, you start watching that clock right now. 5:12 left in regulation. Joe Montana, not the greedy kind of quarterback.
And in this situation, Jim, he doesn't have to be that greedy. He really does not, because
holding, Number 38, receiving team on the return. First stop.
He has plenty of time to move the length of the field. 5 minutes and 12 seconds. Still has his three timeouts, so there's more than enough time. Don't get greedy in this situation.
We go into overtime. I'm going to put your overcoat on. Let's get Julie up here. From the 22-yard line of the 49ers, in motion comes Freddie Solomon. Lindbergh Elliott. First down, San Francisco. Tommy Myers, the 9-year veteran from Syracuse, in there on the stop for the Saints, a 22-yard pickup. And again, as Jim Hill described, you take what the defense will give you. Another look as if you're Joe Montana.
And now it appears that the Saints are really starting to just give the game away. And by that I mean physically they are not up for this game right now. San Francisco is really starting to push them around. They don't have the enthusiasm that they had in the first half.
The offensive line of San Francisco controlling things now the way the New Orleans Saints offensive line did in the first half. Solomon in motion. Lindbergh Elliott has a convoy around the right side. There's a fine defensive play, but look at Lindbergh Elliott go. They tried to cut him down. Tommy Myers did back at the 45-yard line. Finally, Federspiel chased him down from his linebacker spot. Lindbergh Elliott, low to the ground, somehow maintained his balance and rambled for 8 tough yards. Second down and 2.
The Saints on defense now, Jim, are very, very tentative. They aren't coming up and attacking the offensive unit. I just noticed on that particular sweep, the cornerbacks on the side for the Saints came up to the line of scrimmage and just stopped. You can't do that. You must come up, you must attack the ball carrier, and you have to attack those offensive linemen that are turning to lead that particular sweep, because if you just come up there and stand, what's going to happen is you're going to get hurt, you're going to get some long yardage run against you, and eventually you could end up losing the ball game.
Tonight on CBS, it all starts, of course, with 60 Minutes. Then on Alice, Mel has a change of heart, but it's more than his heart can stand. It's all tonight on CBS. As you look at that fine lineup of programs, those of us that have to get planes back to the East Coast can go back to the hotel and have room service or something and watch 60 Minutes and Archie Bunker's place and One Day at a Time and all of Mel's problems in the diner tonight. The injured player, James Marshall, number 23. From the 49, Montana, 22 of 32, is now 23 of 33. And stutter stepping down the sideline is Donnie Woods, who's in replacing Earl Cooper, all the way down to the Saints' 35-yard line. He did not go out of bounds. A 16-yard pickup, another first down for the San Francisco 49ers. Elix Price, 75, from Alcorn State, in there on the stop as you take a look from ground level.
A great job of running by Don. A missed tackle right here can really cost the Saints a ball game. There's the missed tackle right there. Instead of going out of bounds, Woods fools a lot of people, picks up the first down.
From the 35 of New Orleans, clock is running. 3:15. Solomon in motion, near side. Waymer goes with it. Montana, straight drop. All kinds of time to throw. Looks up in the pocket. Tries to run out of the pocket. He's got a couple of blockers. He'll go out of bounds and stop the clock. The 49er faithful on their feet. The 49er bench on their feet. A very concerned New Orleans Saints bench on their feet across the way. Saints 0-13 coming in. New Orleans looking for that first victory of 1980. You look at the brain trust, Bill Walsh, Steve DeBerg over on the sideline. Eason Ramson, number 80, is checked back in at tight end. Charlie Young is checked out. There is a very nervous, a very concerned ex-All-American from the University of San Francisco. The year was 1951 for Dick Stanford. The moment is 1980. Lindbergh Elliott, a real estate agent right now, down to the 12-yard line of New Orleans. A fumble on the play, but not before the whistle had blown. The Saints thought they had the football. The whistle had blown. The 49ers keep the pigskin.
I'm firmly convinced now, again, Jim, that New Orleans is not physically strong enough. I noticed that a little while ago. They're getting pushed around just a little bit too easy now. They're standing up. The offensive line for San Francisco is so big and strong that they're able to just move people around, and that's the reason why the running backs are able to just get through the line of scrimmage with relatively ease.
Lots of time left. 2.5 minutes to be exact from the 13-yard line of the Saints. San Francisco driving for the tying touchdown. Montana over the middle. He's got his man, Freddie Solomon, inside the 10 all the way down to the Saints' 7-yard line. And that should be, unless somebody calls timeout, the final play just before the 2-minute warning. You look at ground level.
And Joe really threw this ball. I mean, he threw it right on the line. You see the nose of it going down. Great job now, because either the ball is going to be caught or it's going to be incomplete. When the nose is dying like that, you know the defensive player cannot get over there and pick it off.
There you see the score, 35-28. What a comeback by the San Francisco 49ers. The Saints holding on, but barely. 2 minutes left in regulation. We come right back. The Saints 35, the 49ers 28.
Introducing a small wonder, the new Toyota Starlet. Born small to solve big problems. Born small to deliver more miles per gallon of gas than any other car, and designed to help beat higher maintenance costs. The very new Toyota Starlet. Born small. In fact, it just may be the first small wonder of the world.
Oh, 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 what a feeling.
Starlet.
Toyota.
Let me tell you something about blue jeans. You get in a jam up here and you got real problems. That's why I always go for the best tools, like this saw and my Levi's blue jeans. You see, tree bark will chew through most anything, but these jeans bite right back. And Levi's blue jeans got a fit that's made for work, and that's real important when the changing room's 200 feet down.
Intended for Dwight Clark, who caught his seventh touchdown pass earlier tonight, and you saw the frustration after Montana hit him right on the numbers.
And he was wide open, too.
Eason Rampson, number 80, checks back in. And Dwight Clark, a little bit embarrassed having dropped that pass, checks back out. Solomon wide to the right side, the running back, Linville Elliott, and Donnie Woods. Linville Elliott. Touchdown, San Francisco. A 7-yard run around the left end. Randy Gross. Randy Cross, number 51, threw the big block that allowed him to turn the corner. Keith Barnworth, 71, also over there on the left side, and Brent Quillen is the center. Take another look.
Outstanding job by the offensive line. You see what happens is that the 49ers got Linville Elliott to get to the outside. They provided that little tunnel for him to run in, and the Saints just did not get that horse man up to turn it back inside and get into the secondary, make penetration, and make the tackle.
They go 78 yards in 8 plays, and Ray Worsham caught after. Ties up this football game. It's been a dandy. The Saints jumped out in front 21-0. Freddie Solomon goes 57 yards with a punt return, 21-7. It's 35-7 New Orleans at intermission, and the second half has been all San Francisco, 28 unanswered points.
This ball game is not over yet. Here's another look at that fine touchdown run by Elliott.
Now watch him give him the hip right there. He gives him the hip and he comes back out.
That's the big move. That's the real big move, faking to the inside, then ducking back to the outside. Breakdown on the part of the Saints from their defensive secondary as far as coming up and supporting and making the tackle. But you have to give credit where credit is due. The 49ers did an outstanding job of coming back when really the odds were against them at halftime when they were down that much.
Word from across the bay now in Oakland. This is a final. The Dallas Cowboys upset the Oakland Raiders 19-13. 19-13, Dallas on top over Oakland. What that means now is Dallas and Philadelphia in a virtual tie in the NFC East. Oakland and San Diego remain tied in the AFC West. Jimmy Watt. The last man, number 57 for the San Francisco 49ers, Danny Bunn. perhaps a game-saving tackle.
This game is not over. You got a minute 43 on the clock. The Saints have three timeouts. Archie can move the ball down the field in field goal range, even though it would be into the wind. There's enough time left.
There's that Dallas final. The Cowboys are tied with the Eagles, and the Chargers get a break with Oakland's loss. They stay tied in the AFC West. 2 weeks to go. Manning sends Ike Harris in motion to the top of your screen. Wes Chandler to the near side. Chandler's open, but he can't find it. Archie Manning goes down. Archie Reese grabbed Archie Manning. And Jim Hill, on a crossing post pattern, Wes Chandler was all alone at the midfield stripe, coming from the right to the left side, but Manning was looking to the left, rolling to the left, and never had a chance to see him. He was looking for Ike Harris the whole time.
That's one of the problems you have when a quarterback runs in one direction and you have someone crossing from the other side. Even if he is open, the defensive people know that, and they know that it's a very difficult thing for a quarterback to run to his left and spot someone coming back from his right. This is the time now when the Saints must pick up big yardage. They have to take a couple of chances. They only have 1:36 left. They have three timeouts left. They're going to have to take a couple of chances because they're so deep in their own territory.
The executive producer of the NFL Today, Charles H. Milton III, not a bad tennis player. Produced by Marvin F. Muse, directed by Andy Kindle, who picked the Saints to win this game at our production meeting last night and is now nervously biting his tape recorder down in the truck. Our associate producers, our technical director, Andy Bass on audio. And while we have an opportunity from all of us to all of you, we'd like to wish you and your family the happiest of holiday seasons, a very fun-filled time of the year. We hope you're all extremely careful if you're out on the highways over the next couple of weeks, because you know that over the holidays it's somewhat accident prone. So from all of us at CBS, happy holidays. Please drive with care. Our spotter is Mel Corvin. Our statisticians, Kurt Canale. And you might be hearing a lot of these names again, because this one could be a long way from being over. We've got a minute 36 left to go in regulation. We are deadlocked, 35 all. I'd like to be some guy who went to sleep at halftime, figuring, oh, the Saints, you've got this one tied up, 35-7. You turn your set back on now, tied up 35-35. Say, whoa, what happened? Archie looks for Henry Childs. He's got his man, but shy of first down yardage by about a yard and a half. Terry Totolo, the ex-Philadelphia Eagle, now in his fifth year from UCLA, in there on that tackle. Saints go with a hurry-up offense.
They need to pick up at least 40 more, about 40 more yards before they can reconsider.
Really, yeah, right now, they need to pick up the first down. They do. Now the Saints will probably call one of their timeouts. Danny Bunn's in there in the tackle. I'll tell you what, he's played like an all-pro today. First down, New Orleans. Archie goes over to confer with Dick Stanford, interim head coach of the New Orleans Saints. They lost their initial outing under Dick last week against the Minnesota Vikings, 23-20. Saints fell behind in that game, 23-0. Dick had a very quiet talk to the troops at halftime, said, you're a much better football team than you'd shown, not only in your first 12 losses, but in the first half here against the Vikings. Now let's go back out and show what you're made of. And that was about it, and they did exactly that. And certainly the San Francisco 49ers, Jim Hill, have shown what they're made of, because just as it would have been easy for the Saints to quit last week against the Minnesota Vikings, it would have been likewise for the 49ers down by 28 points, but they did not quit this afternoon either.
I think Bill Walsh had a very good talk with the 49ers at halftime, and that's why they came out so fired up in the second half.
I'll tell you, the man who must be feeling a little bit of heat right now is Benny Ricardo, because he would be the man they'll call on if they can get into field goal range. Tony Galbraith, but this will be called back, holding against the New Orleans Saints. Keena Turner, the rookie from Purdue. Nope, it's a motion call against New Orleans. That won't help their cause. Kind of a strange play call, too, inside a minute now. Of course, the 49ers are thinking pass. They're playing pass. They're in their prevent, their nickel coverage, if you will.
Illegal motion, number 45. Offense started before the snap. Still first down.
That's Jack Holmes, and that's two times on this drive that Holmes has been called for a motion. The line of scrimmage is the 37-yard line of New Orleans. Saints have the ball. It's first and 15 with 59 ticks on the clock in regulation. You get the idea we're going to be here for a while?
And the people in the secondary, you know their hearts are really throbbing. Yes, we just may be here for a while, yeah.
Chandler to the right, Icarus to the left. They need about 30 yards to get in range for Ricardo. Tony Galbraith. Heard footsteps in the person of number 52, Bobby Leopold, the rookie out of Notre Dame. Certainly a very catchable ball for Tony Galbraith, who has caught 5 for 41 yards so far this afternoon. There you look at a nervous Benny Ricardo.
No reason in the world for Galbraith to drop that one. It was right there.
Benny Ricardo has missed 2 of his last 4 extra point attempts coming into this football game. He's been perfect, 5 for 5 this afternoon. And Ricardo has missed, check this, 6 out of his last 7 3-point attempts. Saying, guys, give me a break. Panic needs 15 yards. They go to Jack Holmes. 4 Saints in front of him. Holmes stripped down from behind. Way short of first down yardage with 45 seconds left. Lawrence Pillars has been a pillar over on that right side. Moved into the nose guard spot after Archie Reese went down with a knee injury. Miller is getting up a little slowly himself. Manning will go over and confer again as the Saints call timeout. It's 3rd down and 7. Interesting to speculate here, Jim Hill. On 3rd and 7, if you don't pick up the first down, do you go for it and maybe turn the ball over to the 49ers around midfield, or do you punt it away and play for possession in the overtime session?
Well, I think you should play to win. I don't think there's any other way to look at it except play to win. But one of the most important things, or the most important thing I think that the Saints should be concerned about now, is coming back with the play from the sidelines that Archie's going to bring back. His pass receivers must remember that they have 7 yards to go for the first down. They must go at least 7 yards and then come back for the ball. The good pattern for these people to run now are curl patterns, or comeback patterns, or sideline patterns. Make sure that you run at least 9 to 10 yards deep and then come back for the ball. It's not going to do you any good to run 7 yards and come back, because then you'll be faced with that critical decision. I think that decision should be to go for it.
Well, if you go back 2 plays ago to the pass that Tony Galbraith dropped, if I were San Francisco, I would come with a blitz right now, not give Manning too much time. You know he's got to throw the ball. You give Archie more than 3 seconds, he'll find somebody. They need 7 for the first down. He's going for all of it to Wes Chandler. No! Dwight Hicks. In his second year, former Michigan Wolverine under Bo Schembechler, comes up with the interception. It's been that kind of a year for the New Orleans Saints.
They had 2 plays to get 7 yards. I question that call just a little.
I agree with you.
I think they should have tried to get the first down, then go from there. But now they're facing overtime, and you know what? Anything, of course, can happen in overtime.
Dwight Hicks, number 22, as you look on the replay right there, that's his 4th interception of the year. Couldn't have come at a better time if you're a San Francisco 49er from ground level. Another look at Dwight Hicks, and Chandler wraps his hands around his hips and throws it down, hoping maybe for a fumble that would not come. Now you're Bill Walsh in the San Francisco 49ers, Jimmy. You're down there in be careful country. 35 seconds left to go. You certainly don't want to risk the interception down here. Let's see how they'll play it. Linville Elliott has been the workhorse in the second half. Tries to turn the corner. Tries to get out of bounds, does not, but he is very, very close to first down yardage over there, and certainly has given the 49ers a little room with which to work. Ken Bordelon in there on the tackle. And the 49ers are going to let the clock wind down. Bill Walsh says, we'll take our chances in the OT and maybe win the toss of the coin. that's it. That's the end of regulation. And perhaps a comeback to beat all comebacks. They were down by 28 points. And the San Francisco 49ers have tied up the New Orleans Saints 35-35. The overtime in 1 minute.
Welcome to the future. Brought to you by Fidelity Electronics.
I am Fidelity. Jeff Challenger, your computer opponent. Enter your move.
Now, from the future, a new voice sensory chess challenger. A talented opponent that senses your every move, then illuminates and announces its countermove.
Knight takes queen.
At fine stores everywhere. At Fidelity, our most important product is the future.
Used to be when I had a job to do around the house, it was one-on-one. Me against the house. And since the house was much bigger, I usually lost. Well, I've just changed all that with my new Black & Decker Workmate. It'll hold just about anything I want to work on, from a door to a pipe to a 200-pound dresser. In fact, my Workmate is so good at helping me work, I'm giving it Sunday off.
Workmates available from about $45.
John Burns joined the Army in March and kept us waiting until October. Kathy Wolf joined the Army in May and kept us waiting all summer. If you're a high school graduate or about to be, you can join the Army now and take up to 12 months to report for duty. That way, if you qualify, we can guarantee you the skill training that makes you happiest. And we think a happy soldier is worth waiting for. This is the Army, a chance to serve your country as you serve yourself. Call this number toll-free.
The man in the middle, Dick Jorgensen, the referee. You look at the Susan B. Anthony toss of the coin. Happened just a couple of seconds ago, and you can tell by the New Orleans Saints number 79, Emmanuel Zanders, one of the more spirited Saints who has been with his team and seen it all through their ups and downs over the years, a seven-year man from Jackson State, that the Saints have won the toss, and they obviously will take the football right now, and they will still be to the goal to our left side. What's going on in Seattle?
Well, as you know, Phil Simms wasn't able to play for the New York Giants today. Scott Bruner came in and did an outstanding job for the Giants as they beat the Seattle Seahawks 27-21.
Doesn't affect too much in the standings. A couple of big games around the league today, though. Cowboys hang on and win against Oakland across the bay. So Dallas, by virtue of that win, coupled with Philadelphia's loss to Atlanta, they're now in a tie in the NFC East, and there are two games to go. Chargers lost, get blown out at RFK Stadium to the Redskins, but Oakland loses too, so nobody changes, moves up and down at all. In the AFC West, they're still in a tie, but your Los Angeles Rams, they've got some problems.
They were defeated by Buffalo in overtime 10-7, so Atlanta leads the NFC's Western Division by two full games with two to go.
Of course, tomorrow, Don Shula's Miami Dolphins playing host to the New England Patriots. Patriots still locked in a big battle in that AFC East with Buffalo. That game will be heard on CBS Radio. I'll only mention it once, Marvin. So we are set to go. Whoever scores first takes home all the marbles. 35-35. It's been a dandy.
Certainly has. In the overtime period, each team gets two timeouts. We'll play a full 15 minutes unless someone scores. At the end of that 15-minute period, if no one has scored, then we go home all tied up. But I don't think anyone really expected two different games this afternoon. The first half belonging to the Saints, the second half belonging to the San Francisco 49ers.
I'll tell you what I don't expect. I don't expect to go 15 minutes without somebody scoring. I mean, they put 70 points on the board here. This has been a shootout at the OK Corral. 35-7. New Orleans wins the first half. 28-0. San Francisco wins the second half. But it's whoever can score first now wins the ball game. And New Orleans hasn't done that yet this year. And again, for the San Francisco 49ers, the five wins posted this year better the last two seasons put together in the win column. Worshing to kick it away. Jimmy Rogers to put it away. Yeah. Who else? Number 57, Danny Buns, in there on the tackle. And one of the San Francisco 49ers has been injured down there at the 23-yard line. Let's check the stats, if we can, on both Archie Manning and Joe Montana in the passing department, because when you see 70 points put on the board, you know the quarterbacks are doing something right. It's been an aerial shootout. Archie Manning, 23 of 36, 372 yards. And Joe Montana, 24 of 35, 285 yards. It'll be the New Orleans Saints operating first and 10 from their own 27-yard line. 14:51 left in the overtime session. We're tied 35-all when we come right back.
TCR Crossfire Racing, only possible on the wide open track. For the first time, two loops connected by four lanes of no man's land called Crossfire Alley. To win this race, you must stay on the suicide loop and risk a head-on collision with a jam car. So every lap becomes a countdown of nerves, speed, and lane-changing skill. And only TCR's got it. TCR Crossfire Racing, wide open racing from Ideal.
This ranch doesn't run without horses. And the horses don't run without you. But when you've hammered out a day's work, you meet up with Miller Time.
When it's time to relax.
Time for the best tasting beer you can find.
One beer stands clear.
Miller High Life.
If you've got the time, we've got the beer.
Need your help. Is it me or my 1981 Toyota Corolla? Watch. See what I mean? I know Corolla looks like a million, got plenty of style, not to mention a peppy 1.8-liter engine. But I ask you, is it me or my Toyota Corolla?
Give me a ride to the library.
Tell me, was it me or my Toyota Corolla?
Oh, 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 what a feeling!
Your Corolla!
Jim Kelly, Jim Hill back with you. You look at a nervous couple of coaches right now. Dick Stanfill on the left, Bill Walsh over on the right. And we have got 14:51 left to go in this overtime session. You look for any indicators off of the earlier season performances. The San Francisco 49ers won in overtime at this stadium, 24-21, against the St. Louis Cardinals. This is the fourth time in NFL history there have been two overtime sessions in the same stadium. You look at Tony Galbraith. First down. Bobby Leopold in there in the tackle. Galbraith, a good afternoon, both rushing and receiving. His 14th carry for a total of 73 yards. But you look for a play he didn't make, Jim Hill, which hurt the Saints just before the end of the game. That little pass, a swing pass out of the backfield that he dropped.
That hit him right in the midsection, and that could have been one of the biggest plays to go against the Saints in the ballgame.
Number 59, that's Willie Harper, checks out for San Francisco. Craig Bukey checks on in, number 54. Right side linebacker, Archie Manning to Tony Galbraith. Fights his way up to the 40-yard line. Brought down there by Craig Bukey, the man who just came in, the rookie from Tennessee. Second down, 8 yards to go from the 40-yard line. Manning sends Wes Chandler out wide to the right side. Ike Harris flanked out to the top of your screen to the left side. Running backs are Tony Galbraith and Jack Holmes, and Manning will put it up to Jack Holmes, who's had the good hands all afternoon up near the 43. Jim Stuckey stuck him there, shy of first down yardage. Jack Holmes, that's his fifth grab in the afternoon. Check it, his fourth grab for 43 yards.
You watch the crowd get up now.
Third down, 3 yards to go. You look at the San Francisco defense about to dig in, and you look at the New Orleans huddle as they've come up with a third down play. Usually on third down and short yardage, they'll go to Tony Galbraith, either passing or running. And there he is. And this one is coming back. Holding against New Orleans will negate a Galbraith first down. Bobby Leopold ran him out of bounds. the rookie from Notre Dame. And we've got an injured New Orleans Saints down on the field on the 40-yard line. So New Orleans has all kinds of problems.
Jim, I think it goes back to all about midway through the fourth period when the Saints came out. They knew they had to move the ball. Archie came out from took the snap from center one time, remember, fell down on it. He fumbled it. The next time they had an illegal man in motion.
Holding number 68, offense, decline, fourth down.
And from that point on, the ball game has just been all in the favor of the 49ers, even though they played good football before then.
Okay, on the left side of your screen, you can see Fred Stewart right there holding. Good work, Andy, down in the truck. By golly, he picked the Saints to win, and he's staying with them. He's even freeze-framing on the Saints. That's Taylor, number 71, Jim Taylor, third-year man from Missouri. Now, 60 minutes, we will join in progress because of tonight's overtime game. In progress, we will join 60 minutes. Then on Alice, Mel has a change of heart, but it's more than his heart can stand. All tonight, along with the rest of that fine lineup on CBS. To talk about Hart, Jim Hill's fiance is here. Should probably be a bride before this game is over. Fourth down and three. Russell Erksleben to boot it away. Freddie Solomon has broken one. They'll watch it bounce. As everything else has gone in the second half, it bounces backwards against the New Orleans Saints, and the 49ers come to life. At their own 27-yard line, and the crowd comes to life as well. 12:36 left to go in the overtime session. A 28-yard punt by that man, Russell Erksleben. Well, Joe Montana is certainly no stranger to circumstances such as this, despite the fact that he has been starting for only 2 weeks. You might recall a bowl game about 2 or 3 years ago when his Irish of Notre Dame were locked up in a pretty good struggle right there. Montana came on in the last couple of minutes and marched his team right down the field and threw the winning touchdown pass. Landville Elliott, 6 foot even, 210 from Northeast Missouri State, thrown down by the 9-year veteran from Kentucky, Joe Fetterspiel, as you look at a very concerned Dick Stanford. Linville Elliott now, obviously his finest game of the year, Jimmy Hill, 14 carries.
And he's done a lot of it really on his own. He's been getting some good blocking from his offensive line. But one of the things that makes Linville such a good runner, especially this afternoon, is that he's been so busy. And by that, he's always kept his legs running and moving and trying to present a very small target for the defense to hit.
14 carries, 100 yards for Linville Elliott. For the entire season, he had 157 before today. They try the left side. They get up near first down yardage in the vicinity of the 35. You see some of the turf coming up there. Darylin Moore and Fetterspiel in there on the tackle. Again, they are right around the second base area now where the San Francisco baseball Giants play. And Dick Jorgensen, the referee, has called for the measurement. 11:50 to go in. That's the turf we were telling you about, right around second base there. That has led to some suspect footing at that part of the field. You see Montana saying about a jumbo hot dog, shy. One of those foot-long hot dogs, shy of first down yard. Now you can see him doing a little, what they call the ground crew out here. Third and a foot by 49. The same way Joe Montana rushed for a touchdown earlier, he has just rushed for a first down now. Clock continues to wind down, 11:40. And they'll unstack about a ton of beef down there in the vicinity of the 37-yard line.
On the quarterback draw, which is not a bad play to try and execute in this particular area of the field. The key to the quarterback draw is to fake going in an opposite direction and then come back. That particular time, that's what Joe did. As you mentioned, Jim, that's the same kind of play that he scored on early in the ballgame. But the officials, just to be certain, are going to bring the chains in and measure.
I will get another shot of that turf and how badly it's torn up down there between the 20 and the 40-yard line. There you can see how chewed up it is. It looks like Secretariat and a few of his friends have run a mile and a 16th over. By the length of the football, the 49ers pick up the first down, as we called it for you. From the 37-yard line now, the 49ers have the football. 11:40. Clock continues to wind down now in the overtime session. Remember, whoever scores first. Touchdown, field goal, safety. Slot to the left side with Freddie Solomon in the slot. Clark is outside. Linville Elliott did well just to get back to the line of scrimmage. Good penetration that time by Joe Fetterspiel, the veteran from Kentucky, over on the left side to force the play inside before Chuck Evans, 59, and Groom, 78, got in there to bring down Linville Elliott. And another New Orleans Saints player is injured on this play. They're falling like flies right now.
But they are really giving it their best shot. I have to take my hat off to them. They played great in the first half. They didn't play that well in the second half. And here in the overtime period, from a defensive standpoint, they're still coming, they're still hitting, and they know that this is their one shot to win a ball game, to win their first ball game this year.
That's Darylin Moore. Darylin Moore, 74, the 8-year man from Oklahoma, who goes off. Tell you what, if you're going to take your hat off, will you give it to me? Because I'm cold.
It is a little nippy here, isn't it?
Again, the concern of Dick Stanford, who has done really a fine job keeping the morale of the New Orleans Saints up over the last two games. Second down and nine. Montana looks to the air. He looks. He's got Archie Clark, and Archie Clark had the ball just popped loose. You certainly can't fault the receiver on that one. He was stung by David Wehmer, the rookie out of Notre Dame. I want to tell you, Archie Clark has had two vicious hits put on him so far in this football game. You look again.
And for just a split second here, you may have thought that this pass was complete, but not so, as Wehmer came up and wrapped that right arm right on the ball, and it just popped loose. A good defensive effort there by Wehmer.
And Wehmer has come on very strong. He had a couple of shaky games early in the season, but Dick Nolan and Dick Fetterspiel have stuck with him, and the rookie, to his credit, has performed over the last 5 or 6 weeks. Linville Elliott on a sweep. They try to turn it inside and string it out. And I'll tell you, the man who made the play isn't even in your picture right now. And now we get roughing over on the sideline right in front of the New Orleans Saints bench. The man who made that play for New Orleans, Jimmy Marshall, the right side cornerback, Jim Hill, came up, took a shot at Linville Elliott, but delayed him just enough for the hesitation that the rest of the Saints secondary was able to come up and penetrate, and somebody came up a little bit too late.
Now that's a silly foul. I'm talking about silly as far as the Saints are concerned. You just force the man out of bounds. If anything, you dive over and do anything you can in order to get out of the way and not try to hit him. Here's a look at the ball carrier going out of bounds.
First move.
That's a defensive player.
Unnecessary roughness, number 96, defense. First down.
Steve Parker, rookie out of Idaho, made a rookie mistake.
Really no sense in that at all.
10:42 left to go. Six-yard line in New Orleans. Montana, Clark signals, gives to Linville Elliott. He rambles for 10 yards and another first down for the 49ers. Tommy Myers made perhaps a game-saving tackle. Linville Elliott, what a game he's having. James Owens checks out now, or checks back in. Linville Elliott had only carried the ball 38 times for 157 yards coming into this game, and already he has carried for 110 yards on 17 carries. You look at Ray Wershing over on the 49ers sideline, warming up into the practice net. Now they say his forward momentum was just stopped the length of a football shy of first down yardage. Now, Jimmy, you've got second down and less than a foot to go for the first down. You've got a down you can waste.
You certainly can waste it, or you have it to play with, but you don't want to get foolish with it and give the defense something that they can take advantage of. I think that the thing that San Francisco is concerned about is keeping the ball right in the middle of the field.
Well, let's see what they do. They go for Price, 75, made the stop for New Orleans. We mentioned James Taylor from New Orleans, who went down the last time New Orleans had the ball. The Saints starting left tackle, a knee injury, will not be back. That's if New Orleans should stop this drive by San Francisco and get the ball back. First down, 10 yards to go at the 35-yard line. The New Orleans Saints, their defense, just like the 49er defense had to assert themselves before, has got to do something now. Come up with a big play, maybe force a turnover, stop this drive. Don Woods. Inside the 15. Price again chased him out of bounds. They say now he stepped out of bounds back at the 14. Check at the 19-yard line. The 19 is where they say he was. Randy Cross, number 51, through the big block over on the right side that allowed him to turn the corner. Helped out by Lindell Elliott.
And, you know, you don't see any Saint defensive players on the offensive side for San Francisco. They just came up to the line of scrimmage and just kind of stopped. And when you do that, you have a running back who has the speed of a Don Woods. He's going to be able to get to the outside and get downfield.
9:27, clock is stopped as Woods ran out of bounds. But right now, the New Orleans Saints defense is rocking back on their heels. Lindell Elliott inside the 15 down to the 12-yard line. Ted Bortolo in there on the tackle for the New Orleans Saints. So right now, the Saints have got to play right up on that line of scrimmage. One man's got to go for the ball carrier, Jim Hill. The other's got to go for the football. Try to strip it loose, force a fumble, some kind of a turnover.
And I think this is a time when we will be seeing the ball carriers for the 49ers to hang on with both hands, try and stay right in the middle of the field and move it on down. If they don't get the touchdown, then they should really get a field goal.
There's the book on Lindell Elliott so far this afternoon. Some kind of performance turned in. Donnie Woods. But this one's coming back. This will be holding against San Francisco. Just as the 49ers are on the verge of putting the game away, the Saints get a break, and it's a big one. Let's see if we can pick it up. Maybe
looks
right
like
there
that,
on
looks
Cross.
Looks like Cross, yeah, looks like Cross. And the officials right on the spot. Threw down
holding
the flag.
Number 51, offense, still second down.
Job by our director down in the truck. Good job by our camera guys who have been doing a fine job all afternoon. Bring you the pictures. Give you the feeling like it's right there in your living room. Second down, 14 yards to go from the 22-yard line of New Orleans. Lindell Elliott tries to pop it across the 20. He does. Gets it down to maybe the 17-yard line. That'll bring up third down now. Tommy Myers on the stop. Now you've got a big play call for both teams. The 49ers, you don't really want to risk the pass interception right here. You've got the football. You're certainly well within Ray Wershing's reign. But if you're in New Orleans, Jim, I think you've got to gamble. You've got to do something a little dangerous right here. You've got to play the guys up tight in the corner, send them in, blitz a little bit, send everybody in to try to prevent not the big chance for big game, but you've got to throw them for a loss a little bit. That's what they did. They played everybody up tight. However, the 49ers get it right in the middle of the football field for Ray Wershing.
Well, that's exactly what San Francisco wanted to do. They didn't want to take any chances at all of giving the Saints the ball by a turnover. And they also wanted to make sure that the ball stayed in the middle of the field to cut down on the kicking angle for Wershing.
Okay, in field goals, Wershing is 13 out of 17. The line of scrimmage, the 17. He'll kick it from about the 26. It'll be a 36-yard attempt, and the crowd will tell you. It's perfect. 7:20 in overtime. A 26-yard, make it a 36-yard field goal by Ray Wershing. And the San Francisco 49ers, who at one time trailed the still winless New Orleans Saints 35-7, have won in overtime. Take a look at the reaction by Ray Wershing and Joe Montana, the holder. And watch the New Orleans Saints as well. Look at Montana, look at Wershing, and then look at Grooms, number 78 for the New Orleans Saints. He just cannot believe it. So that's it in overtime. The San Francisco 49ers 38, the New Orleans Saints 35. The NFL on CBS, a presentation of CBS Sports.